centre court, Wimbledon, the games of the 30th Olympiad 2012. Coming up, the women's singles tennis final. Two players, Maria Sharapova of Russia and Serena Williams of USA. It's a warm and breezy afternoon at Wimbledon. Conditions will be pretty good for this match, 18 degrees, humidity 83%, that's much higher than in recent days. Wind from the south-southwest at 15 kilometres an hour. And it sometimes comes into the centre court and makes it difficult for the players we shall see in the playing of this gold medal match for the women's singles. First of two finals matches to be played later today, the gold medal match for the doubles. There are the court conditions. And we see the two players listed for this afternoon's gold medal match. Court conditions will be very good, except very bare at the baselines and quite rough outside the baselines. And many players have slipped and fallen there in the week of tennis here at Wimbledon. Well, it's a dream matchup, really, between two very glamorous players of the women's world scene, Maria Sharapova and Serena Williams. And it's a match that's much anticipated by the crowds who've been coming to the tennis this week. Players will be introduced and will come on court in just a few moments. They are two of the most accomplished winners of women's tennis in recent times. Up until June the 11th this year, Maria Sharapova was the number one ranked player in the world. And but for injuries in 2009, maybe Serena Williams would have had a longer tenure as the number one ranked player. She was ranked number one in total for 49 weeks up until October 2010. Some Russian supporters there, but really there'll be support for all of the finalists in these matches today. And tomorrow, the final matches tomorrow in the men's singles, the women's doubles and the mixed doubles. Mixed doubles making a return to the Olympic program in 2012, after it was played many years ago. So there are five gold medals at stake in tennis this time and from now on. Well, it couldn't be more dramatic setting for women's and men's tennis than centre court on the grass at Wimbledon. Quite a few times this week we've had the new roof over to make it even more unique, if that can be a term, playing on grass under a roof in tennis. We did see it in the men's singles final at the Wimbledon, the All England Championships, just 2 months ago. And it provides a look for the playing of the game that's not possible unless you can have a roof that opens and shuts and nurtures the grass to keep it growing. Plenty of roof tennis tournaments around the world, including the Australian Open, of course, but they play on a hard court. It's the only court in the world where a major Grand Slam tournament was played on grass. Of course, Serena Williams was the winner on grass just weeks ago at the All England Championships, but Maria Sharapova has won on grass here in the past. It's been a very vibrant and may I say a younger crowd watching the tennis this week. In fact, it's been described as being Olympic tennis buffs as against tennis aficionados who might be the ones who make the appearances at the All England Tennis Championships.
Ladies and gentlemen, our first finalist, representing the United States of America, Serena Williams.
Years of age, Serena coming in with strong form and a glittering career. as has
ladies and gentlemen,
our second finalist.
Representing the Russian Federation, Maria Sharapova.
Russian flag in the stands. Maria Sharapova carried that flag in the opening ceremony, the first female Russian to be offered that honor. Serena Williams is a former world number one, the current Wimbledon champion 2012, but the number four seed here at this tournament. That's because she's still ranked number four in the world, seeding some world rankings, and she's returning from a long series of injuries.
Will be Louise Engzell of Sweden.
So one of the niceties of the game, the photo opportunity before the playing of the match, and now the toss. It goes from chair umpire Louise Engzell of Sweden. It looks like it was won by Sharapova, and she has the right to choose service or ends. And she's happy with the ends she's going to play it, so we'll presumably see Williams open the serve. So now begins the warm-up period. See the royal box there in the background, and there are the individual players' boxes just settling in. This is, you can see the mother of Serena Williams there in the front row with the United States flag draped across as a headwear today. And in Maria's box, there's a coach with the cap on top left, and the woman in front is the American comedian Chelsea Handler, who has her own show, and she's a friend of Maria Sharapova, been with her watching all week. And Thomas Hogstedt, the coach. So there's the record here of Serena Williams. Now, the thing to look at is her maybe her last three results. She's only lost 16 games at the tournament. But look, against Ponareva, Wozniacki, and Azarenka, she's only lost seven games in the last three matches. 6-1, 6-love, 6-love, 6-3, 6-1, 6-2 against three accomplished players. In fact, she pushed hardest by her first round opponent. So no sets lost by Serena, and only 16 games lost in five matches. But Sharapova brings good form here as well. You see that against Shahapir, she was comfortably through. A bit tougher against the British Laura Robson, including a tiebreaker. And then she lost the set against Sabine Lisicki, who beat her here at Wimbledon. And then good form to beat Kim Clijsters, former number one, and Maria Kirilenko. The two Russians met in yesterday's semi-final. Comfortably in that win, 6-2, 6-3 by Sharapova over Kirilenko. Also time for players to, and crowd rather, to settle in to their seats. That's one thing we have noticed about the crowds here at Olympic Week of Tennis. Whereas at the England Championships, the crowds would be well seated before the warm-up started. It's again a little bit more casual as the Olympic tennis tournament tries to find its own mood. A little bit more casual, and the fans just a little bit slower to find their places. But find their places, they will. Maria Sharapova completed a career Grand Slam this year, and she won the French Open in straight sets. She's the sixth female tennis player in the Open era to complete a career Grand Slam, that is, winning of all the Grand Slam titles. Serena Williams is one of the others who has also won all four Grand Slams. So what is interesting is that this match we're to see is for a gold medal. A gold medal is at stake at the Olympic Games, but the winner will also become the second person to win a career Grand Slam, a golden slam, they're calling it, with the four Grand Slams plus the Olympic gold medal. Steffi Graf achieved that all in the same year for her in 1988. And these two young women have spread their winnings of the Grand Slam tournaments over a number of years. But one of them today will add to this new title, Korea Golden Slam. Identity cards of people in the support groups and sitting behind the seat, all of us involved at the games. You must not lose your ID card or you can't really come to any events. And so there are thousands of media, tens of thousands of media, and I think approximately 12,000 athletes here, and I think about 20,000 media. And when you add in security officials as well, there are an awful lot of those swingers. The ID cards around this city in the last week and a half.
1 minute.
A minute to go before the women's singles match begins. Reminding you that the number one seed was the world's number one ranked player, Victoria Azarenka. She lost in the semi-finals yesterday to Serena Williams. And the world's number two player was Aggie Radwanska, who was a finalist in the women's tournament, and she lost in round one to Julia Gurgis of Germany, who then later was eliminated by Maria Kirilenko. So today, expect to see lots of power from Williams. She's a power player. She's bigger in stature, as you can see, 73 kg she weighs. From a smaller body size, she is 1 meter 78 tall at 5 feet 10.
Ladies and gentlemen, Maria Sharapova won the toss and chose to receive.
And Sharapova here is 1 meter 88 tall at 6 feet 2, and she weighed 59 kgs. That's just a little over 9 stone in
time.
Empiric measurements. So Williams has more power than Sharapova in terms of the service game, but we've seen some wonderful form in aggressive baseline play from Sharapova this week. Exit hitting of the angles, and she will be more, shall we say, agile than her opponent Williams. So those are the ingredients I'm expecting will be there for the watching as this women's gold medal match unfolds. Well, not quite yet. There's a bathroom break or a visit underneath for Serena. Maria Sharapova, she says, to play in the Olympic Games is a dream. This is her first Olympic Games. In 2008, she wasn't available to play. She's been around the scene for a long time. She won the Wimbledon Championships in 2004. But she couldn't play in 2008 because she took virtually a year off her shoulder injury, and many months of recovery after surgery brought her back into play. But she, for all the glittering wins she's had, she has never played in Olympic Games and therefore never won a gold medal. But she says when she was growing up in Russia, tennis was not a very big part of sport at all. she watched the Olympic Games on television and wanted to be part of it. She says tennis is now very important to Russian sport, and that's why she wants to be part of it. She actually lives in Bradenton, Florida, and of course is enormously wealthy from her winnings and endorsements from the sport. But so too is Serena Williams. In fact, we've got the number one and number two ranked rich female tennis personalities on court here in this match. Louise Engzell of Sweden is today's chair umpire. From the chair umpire, Sharapova won the toss and has elected to receive. So we will see the early service power from Williams. But don't underestimate the serving capacities of Sharapova. When it's on, and it has varied over the year, when it's on and on form, it's a very dangerous weapon as well. London Ready? Olympics 2012. Expression of power from Serena Williams, never better shown than in that opening game. Three aces, and there are bound to be more of those. And you might be asking, when's the tennis going to start? Certainly a fantastic beginning there by Williams. Okay, let's see how it goes for Maria Sharapova.
Oh!
wind seems to be an early issue. There's the second great player from the Williams family. They're playing together in the doubles final. Venus Williams. See, there is a lot of early power from Serena. Two games to love, isn't it? It's two games, two love games to love. A rarity for Serena Williams yesterday in her semi-finals. She only had five unforced errors in the whole match against the number one seed in the tournament, Azarenka. So there's our first example of what Sharapova basically has to do to test Williams, move her about and force her into errors. But when the ball does come into the hitting zone, that's where Williams is so dynamic. To be fair, it is blustery down there. See the hair on Sharapova, and also the way the the ball was just fell short of the racket there as she lunged for it. So game point for Williams.
Game, Williams. Williams leads 3 games to 1.
Well, so far in 3 games, we've seen all of the valid pre-game points come into play. Sharapova, a strong baseline player, but likes to play angles from her shots at the baseline to make her opponent run or to force her opponent error. Williams, on the other hand, possessing a very big serve and good power play to just hit winners. Yesterday against as a ranker, she hit 33 winners in 2 sets. Her opponent hit 12, and she's the number one player in the world as a ranker. So what we're seeing so far in the first 3 games is a continuation of what Williams has shown us in recent days.
Ladies and gentlemen, take your seats quickly, please. Thank you.
So lots for Sharapova to think about as she comes back.
Thank you.
Williams at the net there. She's pretty competent at the net. The lob by Sharapova didn't test her. That was a good intention, but smashed away. Sharapova. Sharapova's intentions are good, but the pressure is coming from the shots of Williams that doesn't allow her to hit her angles or the straight shots down the line to move Williams around. That one was an example. She hit it too big. 15-30. So net court favoured Sharapova here.
advantage, Williams.
And the pressure on that point came from the very good return from Williams, putting it right into the feet of Sharapova. So she lacks authority on the next shot. Becomes a winner for Williams, and now she has a break for four love. Two serves on this side have gone well past the service line. Some of the players were saying that there were little holes at the baseline. We can see it's very rough in some parts down there, very well worn. And that seemed to be hitting some spot there that gave Williams virtually no bounce. And you can see there's problems at that end in the throw up. System is in action in this match. Three for each player's per set. And that was a strange shot by Sharapova, cramped in the backhand.
Williams.
So it's all Williams at the moment, really. Happy perhaps up in the Williams camp. There's Venus, who did play in the singles and played pretty well actually. She beat the number 9 seed Sara Errani in round 1. Nothing going right at all for Sharapova. Yes, Venus then beat Wozniak, the Canadian, and then lost to Angelique Kerber out of Germany. 7-6, 7-6, so she brings good form as well. But this is, wow, such a surprise that it's so one way at the moment. Give it a wow again. And she serves her sixth ace. And a little pirouette. Typical winner from Sharapova at last, but still facing game point against her. Sharapova was challenging.
It was
called good. So if it's out, there'll be a second serve. And well, there you go.
Second serve.
It was out by some margin. Same conditions for both players. It's a gusty, breezy wind, causing a few, almost causing some wardrobe malfunctions. Still the game point for Williams.
Okay.
Williams helped already by seven aces, which if you think four constitutes the equivalent of a game, she's nearly won two of the five games by services that are clean ace of the opponent. This is some wonderful shot showing you the power of this woman, as she is in very good form. Just repeating those harsh facts for Sharapova to look at. Only five unforced errors in her semi-final yesterday, but hit 33 winners to 12. And she's conceded only 16 games in five matches here, and only seven games in the last three, which arguably are against the tougher three players in the better form at this
tournament. Take your seats quickly, please. Thank you.
Sharapova unable to get her characteristic ground strokes moving. She has to win this serve while she concede the first.
Thank you. Cut.
of a hit 40 love, but still Williams swinging. Took it right back to Sharapova's feet and got the point. She goes swinging. Again, tremendous length from Williams, just dropped it inside the baseline.
Yes.
So Sharapova's confidence on the reply skies it out of court. That was a beautiful Sharapova point.
Advantage, Sharapova.
A beautiful Sharapova point, in as much as she made her opponent go blackguard to blackguard across the baseline. Full marks to Williams. She ran very well to get it back into play. A couple of times when we thought she might not have. Now it's advantage to Sharapova. Rubbish on the court. Three double faults, four unforced errors so far by Sharapova. Hit the paint on the line.
Advantage, Williams.
There it is. The chalk comes up. And so we go through to set point after just 29 minutes. Crowd are having fun here, but it's a serious match and an awful lot at stake. Serena Williams in control. Takes the first set, 6-love. I think it's fair to say when we saw play start and we saw very few rallies, but the opening game had three aces in it from Williams. That was her just taking ownership of the set, and she never released her grip on it. Occasional points won by Sharapova, but really an emphatic early statement by Serena, winning by 6-love in 30 minutes. There it is. These are the horror figures for Sharapova to think about. Most aces, more aces by Williams, more double faults by Sharapova. First service percentage by Williams up at 75. Unforced errors, well, four each. And 30 minutes of play.
Second set, Williams to serve.
So the way the games have unfolded in this match, it's Williams serving first again. So here's her chance to take ownership of the second set. That was amazing. The three aces at the start of the first set. Coming out of the top of a top spin.
30-15.
Big kicking second serve, mixing it up, and then wiping away a forehand.
14-15.
Shot here takes her feet about 8 and 9 inches off the ground. Into the corner. Cold serve, all power. One love.
First game, second set.
So a bit of a hush coming over the crowd at what they're seeing here. The question is, can Sharapova recalibrate enough to work out a new way to get into this match. It is totally going one way at the moment. Not really like Sharapova can get into the match. He can't get in so far to any games. Let's see how she goes with new balls. You can see how focused Williams is. She's disappointed that one didn't get back into play. And just a bit of a skid there. Not as bad as some of them we've seen earlier in the week. Thomas Berdych fell about 7 or 8 times. And there's another shot coming right back towards the feet and cracking the ground stroke.
15-13.
Reply to the return of Williams. Another break chance. Plenty of sympathy around for Sharapova, but from my point of view, this has got to be total admiration for what Williams is doing here. She is demolishing a young woman who up until June the 5th was the world's top player. Great shot down the line by Williams. Just keep on coming. 40 love now. Halfway through the second set. Well, we could be.
40 love. leads 3-0.
Safe to say we're seeing something special here from Serena. And the only thing left to offer on behalf of Maria is there any bounce back? Is there any comeback that she can bring to the match? Seeing that it's this far gone, she's giving it plenty, and she's given the tournament, the Olympic tournament, plenty this week with some wonderful matches and some very good wins. But all of that is in the past. History is here and now, and it's running away from here. She hasn't won a game. Williams has won 9. And there's the phone from the Russians. Perhaps what does it look like to you at home? Because it looks pretty bad here. And well, there's no sign of rain.
Time.
And if there were, they just put the roof across. Fighting qualities of Sharapova. They are there, but they're suppressed and subdued at the moment by this woman, Serena Williams.
Thank you. Thank you.
It's all a distraction, isn't it? Comes off the racket, high into the stands, caught by that young man. The focus is, what is Williams doing here to her opponent? There's a rally where the wind did come to Sharapova. Just the fifth winner, as against 18 by her opponent. warm applause. It took 45 minutes.
Williams leads 3-1.
45 minutes it took for Sharapova to win a game, but she's on the board. He's going to challenge that one. There was dust came up, but it could be just dust from that bare patch you see there. Let's look. This was well and truly in.
40-15. Sharapova has two challenges remaining.
Double fault by Williams. That's a rarity, just a second. People and many at home, I know, will be asking, are we seeing some game-changing moments here? Just not quite so authoritative in the last few moments, and now a break chance for Sharapova. stepping in to take it. This is her first break point chance in the match. Better shot making by Sharapova in the last two games. To the stand and deliver of Williams to bring it back to deuce. Bounce there, wasn't it? Sharapova is running out of games here in which to make her mark. The break serve, she hasn't looked like it yet. Winners for Williams 20, for Sharapova 5, aces 8-1 by Williams. People have come a long way to watch this Olympic tennis tournament in London, so the photo opportunities have been seen all week. Serena's mother there, bottom row, second from the right, we've seen twice. Comes Serena at 4-1. That was the 50th point in the match won by Serena. as against 23 by Sharapova. Chelsea Handler there to the left in the sunglasses. That looked out. It's going to be checked by Williams. No, it's called out. Love 40. I thought the previous one by the baseline looked long. It wasn't. We've had 58 minutes of play in the gold medal match at the games of the 30th Olympiad in London. And here is Serena Williams, here is Maria Sharapova, the two finalists. And after just less than an hour's play, Williams is serving for the match. She's serving for the match, the gold medal, and the career golden slam. Serve is 189 k's.
Don't give up, Maria. Number 18 to
go. Look at the speed of that one, 193. She's hitting these fireballs harder.
Thank you.
time for rally. Maybe the best point of the match. But still, it goes Williams' way. In this rally, Sharapova's good enough was not enough. Once again, the winning of the point went to Serena Williams. Look at the concentration she's offering up to this match. She's just 2 points away from the gold medal. Another ballistic missile goes down. A tennis ballistic missile from Williams. Nine aces. She began with aces. Will she finish with an ace at gold medal point? Gold medal point in just a little over an hour. Began with three aces, finished with aces. Gold medal to Serena Williams over Maria Sharapova. 6-love, 6-1. And that is a sensational gold medal performance. Sharapova brought good form to the final. Serena brought excellent form to the final. And not many people would have predicted such a gap at the end. There's a sister, Venus, also a top player, of course, the former world's number one. We're seeing some snazzy moves as we saw real power on the court. Was she playing with the tennis racket or was she playing with a big spanner? She blew the challenge of Sharapova away. 6-love, 6-1. And the amazing thing is she'll be back. And it's a golden career slam where a player wins all the tournaments of the Grand Slam and adds the Olympic gold medal as well. And only Steffi Graf has done that. And that puts this victory in proper context as well.